bet that's what Beast was talking about. Hmm. That logo looks familiar. I've seen this before at Antique Greenleaf's. Huh. Empty. Either he's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any. Right. Not very appetizing. Frozen solid. Who'd want to eat this?
Bigby Wolf?
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you? You interested in a particular cut? Let's see. What do we have in stock? Let's see what we got here. Flank steak, on special. New York strip. I can have some wild boar in tomorrow, if you like. Sirloin.
I know about the deliveries. The ones going in and out of here.
Well, of course there are deliveries. We don't raise the cows in here.
Beast told me. He said these packages aren't meat.
Well, what else would they be?
Why don't you tell me what was in that package?
Sheriff, did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out. Just wait out front. I'll be right there. I've got a bit of a mess back here. Look, can you come back tomorrow, maybe?
What's the problem? I'm just coming back to give you a hand.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it.
For such an innocent guy, you're acting pretty damn strange, Johann.
I don't know what to tell you. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Gonna kill me. Oh God, she is gonna fucking kill me. He's gonna get me killed. Things I do.
What are you hiding behind that door? Huh?
Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please don't kill me.
Listen. Just calm the fuck down, okay? just want some answers.
Okay. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johann, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both.
What would you do?
It was a simple choice to make in the moment.
They? Do you mean Mary? Bloody Mary?
This isn't my shop anymore. That crew took it from me a long time ago.
Crew?
Fuck. The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me. Took over my storage and delivery a long time ago.
All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one.
Oh, I let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear.
It's all right. I believe you. Calm down.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when. But there...
Shh.
Is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had.
These lights, Johann. Did you warn them I was here?
I had to. You come in here making trouble for me. But you only give a shit now because the Crooked Man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back? I needed help.
Well, I'm here now. I'm gonna sort this all out. So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff. That symbol. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's, brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a... wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this?
Looks like math or something. Shit. Is everybody on here? Do you know anything about this?
I don't know. A lot of fables out there need a lot of things. Maybe just don't touch anything back here. Please.
These are raw materials for making magic. Anti-Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. are they making here?
I'm just a butcher. You want to talk T-bones? That I can do. This stuff is out of my league.
There are a lot of nasty spells you can make with the right equipment. Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables, getting magic from him. Business is booming. He's got all he needs. The raw materials, and with all this gear, looks like they could make just about any kind of magic. A lot of it. And it's pretty clear why.
Oh yeah? Why?
These shackles. He's using slave labor. No wonder people are coming to him for magic. Doing it like this, it's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
When I get my hands on that crooked bastard, I'm gonna make him pay for all this. People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
And that fucker, Crane, knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? Finding the crooked man is so fucking important. Why don't you ask your boss?
Snow.
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got some way. That's right. It was that creepy magic mirror with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the crooked man that way. And leave me alone. Yeah, with stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office.
Crane shattered the mirror and made off with one of the pieces. Probably still has the shard with him.
Well, if they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it. The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn. And if I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me?
Huh?
What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for bloody m-
You won't have to worry, Johan. I'm gonna take him down.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just
That's my fucking
Jack,
system.
What the fuck is going on?
But you,
I'm the guy to keep shit in order, and that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my apartment.
You don't want no... So get the fuck out of my sight. Hit the bricks. See you later.
Hey, what's going on here?
What the fucking hell?
Christ. And this fucking guy too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of... I'm gonna... Rip your fucking lungs out!
I'd like to see you try, you backwards fuckwit!
Oh, big talk! You won't be talking when I'm done with you!
Yeah, I'll be laughing. Ha ha! How you feeling today, Sheriff? Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun?
You ain't so tough.
You fucking... Motherfucker!
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight. Not now. Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Magic Mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. Had useless bitch Snow White and a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends.
Where's the crooked man? How can I find him?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back. Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat.
No time for traveler's checks, huh? He won't be needing this anymore. That sick piece of... Shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the crooked man wanted them dead. That's all it takes.
I don't have to listen to this shit.
Out of smoke? shitty brand.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing. Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
All right, go do it then.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
What are you gonna do now?
We all got our roles to play, Wolf. I'll see ya.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White, I...
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally. Things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
I had to get real persuasive with the Jersey Devil down at the Lucky Pawn, but he told me that the Crooked Man's door, to wherever it is he hangs his hat, it moves. It's some kind of magic door.
Do you think the mirror will be able to find the door, once it's fixed?
That's how Crane did it, and that's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Why'd you put the hurt on Flycatcher? Were you hiding something down at the Tweedles, or was it just for fun?
He worked for them, didn't he? I couldn't be sure that he wasn't involved, and I didn't want him interfering. I was simply endeavoring to make the search a speedy one. Surely you, of all people, can't fault me for getting overzealous in the process.
I don't buy it. I have more important things to deal with right now. You can be sure that we're gonna have a long fucking talk about this when I'm done.
I do so enjoy our talks. I'll wait with bated breath.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
Crane was carrying it for part of the night, at least. I found it in his coat. It's pretty amazing it's still intact after the fight, the kidnapping, and then riding around with Bloody Mary for however...
Yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You-know-who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fabletown.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No budge on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see about...
Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst-kept secret in Fable Town.
Colin stays in my apartment. It's a lot different than a 3-foot-tall frog walking the streets.
What? If the pig doesn't have to go, I shouldn't either. Okay. If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest a wash. Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only home he knows. His old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different.
Look, I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get insulted and I'll be glamoured to the nines, I will.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone. Well, did you or didn't you? Fine, we'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons.
I don't know, but when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
I have to say I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry. I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Yeah, I want to see where he's ended up too.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Just show me where I can find the Crooked Man.
I haven't been feeling well of late. Seems neither of us can cooperate.
Damn.
Perhaps I can be of assistance? Mirror, mirror, keep us sane. Show the door to Crooked Man's domain.
I can always count on you, Bufkin.
I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man's symbol on it.
Hold on.
A door. It moves.
What'd I tell you?
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way. But we have to make a commitment to working within the law.
I'll catch him and bring him back here, alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
Tim,
what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny. I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal.
What is this place?
Or
where is it? I know I'm not in Central Park anymore.
I'm not sure. I've only ever come in through one of the portals. I don't think you can get in from the actual street, but you can't blame him for wanting to make it hard to find. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do.
Fine, lead on.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard, or an escort for that matter. I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it.
I get it. You have a job to do. But you gotta ask yourself if you want to be involved with this guy.
Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good. So I hope you two can come to an understanding.
Don't you realize you're not just minding the door? You work for that crooked bastard, your hands get dirty too.
It's not so bad.
Not so bad?
Are you fucking blind, Tim? He's a murderer.
So you're telling me you agree with everything Crane does? A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Thanks.
Am I some kind of a fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah? Mate, I ain't...
Tell me who the fuck is back there.
Wolf, I got a problem.
I don't exactly know. I just mind the door. The boss is there.
Like Crane before him.
I know that much.
I'm sure he will prove himself quite handy to have in my pocket. Either he's smart enough to see this is for the best, or dim enough to do as he's told.
That won't be necessary. Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Thank you, Tim. I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort, but you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
All right, you got me here. Let's talk.
I've heard stories about you. In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. Is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.